I'm Virgin, and that's Charlie.
I'm Charlie over here.
That's Charlie behind the camera, under the camera. this is Yarn and Glass, episode 8. 8. And
can I make a confession? We started this whole thing before, but I pushed the wrong button.
This is number 3.
This is number 3.
But number 2, you pushed photo.
I pushed photo. So,
and it was so good.
It was good. It was much better than this one's going to be.
It was
right?
Like
it was
perfect.
Spectacular.
And you pushed photo.
I pushed photo. I'm in trouble. So let's go on with the show. Okay.
You are in trouble. Okay. So this, we're getting over it. We can do this again.
Do we have any wine?
We should have wine.
We don't have wine. Okay.
We should have whiskey now.
Whiskey. All right. Go ahead.
Okay. So on this episode, there's going to be knitting some of the finished products is all I ever show, finished objects.
Okay.
And then we'll go to the studio, and there'll be a segment on what I'm working on in the studio.
Okay.
And then there will be, I tried dyeing yarn with avocado.
Yeah.
But so I've never done that. I've done a lot of dyeing of yarn, but not with something natural. And so
Whoa.
I tried avocado pits, and it was really fun. We did a segment on that. There'll be a small segment on the Reimagine art show that was at Texas State Round Rock, that where the VW bus was on display for 2 months. We went to the reception, and I did little tidbits of video there. So I'm going to put it together in a very short piece.
It was neat.
Yeah, that was cool. So, finished objects in knitting. I finished a scrap blanket that has been probably 3 years in the making.
Look at this. I'm gonna go here.
And it's all fingering weight yarn.
All over here.
Yeah.
Over here. The pan over here.
It's a mitered.
Look how big that is.
Mitered square. Yeah, it's a
beautiful.
Nice. It's a very. I've been using it. It's a very nice lap blanket.
Uh-huh.
And I'm calling it done because it's plenty big enough. And I have another one that's half finished in Minnesota. So, you know, it's not for lack of blankets that I will have. and I'm also starting a whole another one called the Northeasterly that a lot of people are making. So that's going to be way down the road when that's
plenty
finished.
Plenty of blankets.
I will have plenty of blankets, but I do like a lightweight blanket for the couch. I use it a lot. So we've been using this one a lot. So that's the mitered square scrap blanket done. Yay.
Mm-hmm.
Then I made I made socks.
Yeah, show us your socks.
Well, actually, I'm going to start with the hat. So I've been spinning yarn for I'd say 8 or 9 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I'd say 8 or 9 years. I have a lot of spun yarn. I'm, you know, not actually too bad at it, but I never knit anything out of my hand spun yarn ever. Isn't that, that's bad.
That's very bad.
I just look at it and I guess I felt like it wasn't good enough, or it wasn't even enough, or I couldn't find the right pattern for it. And I just never did. So it just was in a bin and it just stayed there. And it looked pretty. But I decided to use some of my hand spun yarn, and I made a hat, and it turned out. And it's cool.
Oh, it's nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
I like that.
It's called the Ditto hat that I made a lot of them at Christmas. But this one's heavier because it was a heavier yarn. It's got a double brim, so it's double thick down here, and then it's got cables, and it actually turned out. Who knew? Who knew hand-spun
really nice.
Yarn could be knit?
I had no idea.
Did you know?
I personally didn't know. No, I didn't know that.
No, I didn't either. But I'm kind of excited
it
about
is. Yeah.
Doing that some more. So that's kind of cool. Yeah. So then the other thing that I've finished are socks.
Socks.
Where are they
all?
Okay,
here
this is this.
Whoa, dropping the socks.
Hat. Go away, sock.
Okay, here we go.
This is, I think I might have shown these before, but I can't remember. These are Knit Spin Farm Commentator socks, and it's Targhee wool, which it's really nice wool. She does beautiful yarn.
Yeah.
And this, I'm excited. I'm keeping these because I want them. But I think they will wear really well. This is a nice pair of socks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm excited about these. I have another pair on the needles right now of hers called Iris. Iris, you were here. Iris, it looks like Iris's flowers.
Oh,
Iris,
I got you. Okay.
Iris,
that
you
took
were
me a
here.
while, but I got that. Okay.
Yeah, so those are on the needles, so I'll probably have those next time we podcast.
Okay.
The other pair I finished are the watermelon socks,
okay,
which I am wearing.
Here. Those are the ones I couldn't
I
figure out what
them.
They were when
yeah,
you were doing them.
They're from a sock blank
cool.
from Gail's Art, and it was a double sock blank. It had two strands coming out of it, so that makes the socks equal.
Cool.
But
well,
I do like them. I like them. That's why I'm wearing them today. And the third pair, Charlie bought me an advent calendar, which
what a good
was,
guy am I?
Are you not? Yes,
I'm just
you
a good
are.
Guy. Look at that.
And it was of minis from a hand from a Andy Dyer, Toad Hollow Yarn Company. And I had a lot of these minis because you open a package every day with a different mini of yarn. Different, and it actually was a fairly big mini. I think it was, I don't know. I think it was 20 grams, but it was a lot. So that's that.
Really
I had quite a lot of yarn, and so I made some of it into this pair of socks.
It's impressive.
That I'm calling
actually.
My Advent pair, but actually, the pattern is called Ziggy Plays the Guitar, which is actually a reference to, I think it's two different, I'm not sure which reference it is, but one is Bob Marley's son is named Ziggy, who plays the guitar. And the other one is David Bowie has an album named Ziggy Plays the Guitar.
So it's
one of those.
One of those or both.
One of those. But the zigzag is very cool. These took a long time. I started these in January. So
could I learn how to make those?
It's now April. No. You cannot learn how, nor will you get a pair.
Whoa!
Because
oh my
you
God.
Don't. You really, do you really want bright socks?
Well, I no. But I'm impressed with them. Let's put it that way. I am impressed.
Well, I don't think I'll do this again because there were so many ends.
So much stuff, time.
Well, there were two. You know, there were a lot of ends. Every single color, you have ends that you have to weave in.
Okay.
So,
I know what you're,
yeah.
I don't know anything about that.
I added the black end just to give it some contrast.
Yeah, I like
and to
that.
Give it different heel toes and cuffs. I really like them. I mean,
well,
they're
impressive.
Cool.
I mean,
and who
yeah.
knows? I may make it again someday when the pain goes away. But they're kind of cool. They're fun.
Okay.
And so then I started. Okay, so I am watching a podcast, and I actually started from the beginning because I really enjoy her podcast called Knitting Expat, The Knitting Expat.
Yeah,
And she she's a fabulous knitter, and she's a great designer of patterns, and she's lived in several different places in the world. That's why she's called The Knitting Expat. But she made a pattern called the Pinwheel, and it's a blanket pattern. So you make these squares, and then you sew them together with yarn. And so every square is different. So I have all these squares. I made a mistake on this one. I attached it wrong. I may undo
I
that.
I wouldn't have noticed, to tell you the truth.
It stares at me.
It stares at me,
and it's mocking me. It's mocking
me
for having done it wrong.
Sounds like a movie. The blanket stares at me.
It does in the night. Anyway, I'm making every square be different. And it's made with Knit Picks Comfy Sport Shine Yarn, and so it's very washable and durable. And I believe it's going to end up being a stroller blanket.
Well, that's interesting. Who would want that?
Spoiler alert. Oh, just
later. We'll talk more later.
Somebody close to us might be having a baby. So
yay.
Or is having a baby.
So who is?
We're just kind of keeping it vague right now because I don't know how much I'm supposed to share.
More later. About
anyway,
that.
So that's going to be a blanket, and I love this. I love it so much, and I love her patterns. I have purchased several of her patterns.
Okay.
The Knitting Expat. And then I started on these.
Ooh.
And
yes,
these
babies.
Are addictive.
Let's see that.
These are.
Oh my God.
Oh my, they're so cute.
Kid.
They're little baby
look
socks.
Look at that. Oh my God.
And look at the blue ones.
The blue ones. Okay, with
They're
a turned
different.
down cup, is that? Oh, that's
Well,
neat.
yeah, it has a long leg, but I'm making some of them be turned down and some of them not.
I like that. That's a wild looking pattern there.
That's a crazy pattern,
that's
yes.
Crazy. That's
so I'm trying them in all. I'm changing the pattern. I've used different patterns. I'm
What are you
really
doing?
playing. I'm playing with this and trying
Wow,
to figure
you're
out
having
which.
fun.
Actually, the person that's getting these, it's all going to be an experiment because I have no idea if these will even fit a baby.
Bare metal baby socks.
Yes, these are test knits. They're test knits. That's a good idea.
Test knits. I like that.
So that is the knitting. Did you record this time?
I believe I recorded, but nobody will know if we didn't record it because nobody will see it. If they do see it, they'll know we recorded.
Third time's a charm.
I am a professional at this. You know that, don't you?
I know. You're so good at this.
Are you going to raise my salary?
Right. I'll multiply
plus
it.
One?
I'll multiply it times two.
Nothing plus nothing is nothing.
Nothing
oh,
times
I'm
two.
I'm
is...
here for the pure pleasure. Because
okay,
you make me.
So
okay.
End of segment. We'll go on to the studio segment.
All right, bye.
So in the studio today, or now, I'm working on this Lazy Susan of
okay.
this turtle. It's a commission that I've got to finish in this next few days before we leave Texas. So it's just a turtle. I've made quite a few of those. I cut the legs and the tail and the head out with the saw. And then mosaic his shell and do a
yeah.
border of tiles. And the other thing that I've started, I'll bring it over here.
Oh, okay.
We have, we seem to have a big collection of old stamps in our, in our possession. And I decided to do something revolving around stamps. And we have a lot of old postmarked stamps from foreign countries, old, very old. And I think I'm going to, Charlie routed this frame, he made the frame, and he routed out an area that's the width of a typical
sure.
stamp.
Yeah.
And I'm going to put pieces of stamps all along with this one stamp hole,
it
which
says,
is the
what
love,
does it say?
Love stamp.
Love.
And
okay.
it's... an 8 cent stamp, so this is old. They do a love
uh-huh.
stamp every year, I believe. This is an old one. I think there's actually a sculpture of that somewhere. But anyway, so I've drawn it on here.
Okay. So what are you going to do with those white?
And this is going to be the perforation part, I think. So I will gather them up to look
yeah.
like the perforation. It'll probably be a black border. The thing I'm not sure about. And I'm still deciding about is whether to do it exactly the colors that it is or do a variation of colors, which might be more interesting. I don't know. I'm going to think about that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to start with the perforation because I haven't decided yet, but it might be kind of fun
so
to do
the colors,
the
right
colors
on
of the love stamp.
No, that's kind of...
So I could do it exactly like this picture.
It's, I don't know.
I mean, exactly like the stamp, but that which would be.
Would you like feedback from anybody to say?
Yeah, tell
notes?
Me. If anybody has an opinion, that'd be cool. Whether I should do it exact
uh-huh.
or different variation of colors. But anyway, I just thought that might be fun and use up some of the stamps in this border, which only
yeah.
goes on two sides. I really like that idea that it's only two. And I will... probably Mod Podge them down so
uh-huh.
that they have a smooth surface.
Okay.
So
that's
my
like
other
that
thing.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
Like
so then we're going to turn it off and go to the dining room and show
okay.
the project you've worked on.
That means I got to turn it off. Okay.
So
we're over here now.
So Charlie found, or we found this piece of tappa cloth in Salado, Texas,
cool
and
little town.
Snapped it up. Very cool little town. Has a lot of art galleries, but we have a large tappa cloth on the wall.
There was a contest.
Nobody entered,
but
but that's
you,
a tappa
that's
cloth.
A tappa cloth. That's from one place in the Pacific, and this is in another area.
And
believe.
How did you come by the big one?
Well, it's a long story. I'll make it real short.
Sure.
But my dad was at Pearl Harbor when it was hit in World War II. And before that, he was stationed there and he bought this. So that goes back to probably 1930s, maybe. I'm not real sure, but it means a lot to me.
Yeah,
So that's why that's hanging on the wall, and I really like it.
Charlie put the framing on it.
Charlie put the framing on it. Charlie would be me.
Decided to put
it
to hang it on the wall, which is cool.
On the wall. There's the gnome house right behind it, and there's Eugene, and they were coming down to this one we bought.
So we found this one, which, you know, it's pretty cool to find tablecloth. Cloth. And so Charlie made this very cool frame, which is, it's got, this will be the top, right?
That'll be the top, yeah.
Yeah, and this is the bottom. And it's got the routing edge that he does. And so I made the inkle weaving to put in that routed edge.
Yeah, I'm going to go down. Let's see, I'll go up here and we'll look real close at it.
Yeah, so that will fit right in there. It goes with the colors of the tappa.
Yeah.
And then there'll also be a piece on the side because a piece of inkle loom. So I still have some going on the loom. Because Charlie mounted this on Weedy board and it has a rough edge on the
yeah,
side.
Yeah, I didn't want to
so
show
we're
that.
Gonna cover it up with weaving. So I need
nice.
A whole another piece of this. Yeah. I think it's gonna be really cool
that's
to
cool.
add to the wall. So that's all that's happening in Studio Mosaic Inkle Loom area.
Okay.
I don't know. Anyway. More later.
Bye.
That wasn't bad, right?
I can't.
I am going to dye some yarn, or attempt to dye some yarn, using avocado pits. And I have been saving pits right there, and some of which I took the skins off. I kind of thought I was supposed to, but I don't know that it matters. And I have some of the peeling here. I might also add, I have a big pot of water that I have started to boil. And so right now I've got a big pot of water boiling with 29 pits and all the skins and a few of the peelings of the avocados. And I'm gonna get this to a boil and let it cook for at least an hour. The pits, hopefully, I believe, will act as the mordant for the so that the dye from the avocado pits and skins will adhere to the yarn. So you don't need to add an extra mordant. You have something called tannin in the pits themselves. So we're going to come back when that's been boiling for an hour. So the liquid and all the stuff, it boiled at a low boil for about an hour and a half, and we did our first straining. I made a rookie mistake in cutting the skins off of the avocados, so there were lots of little pieces, but I think we strained most of it out, but I think we're going to strain it one more time. Give me that white spoon and I'll show them the color.
Okay.
So I've got some good color here. That's my color.
It's kind of a red-brown, isn't it?
Yeah, it's kind of a cool color, and it's really pretty rich. So that's kind of cool. And it's about at room temperature now, so I think I can put the yarn in, but I think we're going to strain it one more time before we put it back on the stove. I have three skeins of Knit Picks Gloss Fingering, which is 70% merino wool and 30% silk, soaking in just some tap water. So that's just sitting there, and it's all been tied off. The skeins have been tied off so that they won't tangle.
Okay, it should be going now. Yeah, it's going.
Okay, so I have four skeins of yarn. I was thinking I had three. So here's my yarn. Ready to go,
and it's going to go into
the pot. Ooh, look at that.
Ooh, God, that's purpley red. I don't know. It might be great.
It's kind of a burnt sienna, isn't it?
It's burnt sienna, whatever that is.
That was a crayon.
That was a crayon color. You know, I forgot to tell everybody something.
Yes.
We were talking earlier about the tappa cloth, and I didn't say what it really was, what it was made out of. It was made out of bark, And the bark, I'll do, once you get this in, I'll do a quick pan over to it. But
wait,
the bark,
stay
I'm going to stay right here. I'm not moving. Okay, I'm right here.
Keep going.
I keep going. I'm keep talking. Okay. That is pretty. The tapa cloth was made out of bark, tree bark, obviously. And Virginia's lighting the...
I'm going to put it on low.
Putting it on low.
Go ahead.
Okay, we got that. But anyway, and I think it was dyed by natural, I mean, I'm not sure how they dyed it, but it was, you know, it goes back for hundreds of years. But I'm going to swing over here to the kitchen real quickly. Nobody gets
okay,
sick
cool.
or they tune it. Okay, I'm going over here looking at the, look at that. Oh my gosh. Basketball championship. That's great. Okay, so we're over here in the tapa cloth. This, if you look closely, that is, that's bark. That's tree bark, and it's dyed. It's really a extraordinary thing. So... Now that I told you that, you know what it is, and I'm going to go back here slowly, and I'm going to walk over here,
and we're just going to heat that up.
We're going to heat this up.
We're going to simmer it for a bit, and then we're going to turn it off and leave it in there overnight.
Then we're going to taste it. No, we're not.
Eat it. No.
No, we're not. Okay, so I should turn this off now, maybe?
Yes.
Okay, I'm turning it off now. Bye.
Yeah, so I've pulled the... yarn out of the pot this morning and put it in a strainer, and I got some really nice color. A little bit of variation, which must have been in the bottom of the pot or something, where maybe some of the skin was, but I got some really pretty rose color. I haven't rinsed it yet, so we'll see how the color stays.
Thank you.
this is the end of episode 8, and I wanted to show you the finished avocado yarn, which is really nice.
Yeah, it turned out really good, didn't it?
It's kind of a very pale rose color, very soft pastel. There's four of them, and it's really, I'm really happy with it. It's, it isn't the color I expected. I expected a little tiny bit more brown in it because of the skins, but I'm happy with it. I lost
so what do you have in your
four.
What do you have in your left hand?
Oh, wine.
You're celebrating.
We're celebrating. Yeah, we are packing and leaving Texas. And I wanted to talk about the dye a little bit too.
Yeah.
The I had a lot of dye left in the pot, and you can save it, but we just didn't feel like saving it. So I didn't want to bottle it up. So I had a shirt that cotton shirt that I really liked, and a whole tomato slice flipped onto the shirt, got flipped on, and there was a very pale yellow stain that wouldn't come out.
Right.
So I thought, I'm going to throw that shirt in.
So what happened after?
I threw the shirt in. It turned a beautiful rose color. I loved it. And then I looked at where that stain was, and it was bright yellow. Like, it became like bright yellow.
So that's a lesson learned, right?
We need a dark stain. So it'll be black or navy blue. Next time I dye something dark, I'll throw that in.
So the next one of these, number 9, will be in Minnesota.
Yes,
so it'll be
we're on our way to Minnesota.
2,000 miles north or something like that. Maybe not 2,000. Is that right?
Yeah.
Something kind of close.
A lot of driving. I do want to say that I've closed my Etsy shop for the time being until we're more settled in wherever we are, because we're putting that house on the market.
Yeah.
So I'm not taking those mosaics that are in the shop with me. So
right.
I closed that for a while, but it'll be open. If you ever want to contact me, there's always email or a comment on YouTube. So,
and if you want to buy a house, we'll be glad to sell it to you.
Well, there's that.
We'll make you a heck of a deal.
So that and so that's the end of the episode. And we will see you next time. Thanks for watching.
All right.
Bye from Virginia Charlie.
Bye. Did good. Bye.